Hello, you're watching this video because you want to know how and why to use LUTs in Adobe Premiere Pro. First off, let's talk about what a LUT is. LUT stands for lookup table. It's basically a color or filter preset that you're going to put on your video footage. It's basically like sunglasses for your video. They change how colors and tones appear. Here's how and why you would use a LUT in Adobe Premiere Pro. First, let's start with the why. When used in color grading, LUTs help by giving your video a particular look or style. For example, a LUT can make your footage warmer, cooler, more cinematic, etc. They also help provide consistency. If you're working on a project with different shots or scenes, applying the same LUT to all of the video files using an adjustment layer, which I'll show you in a little bit, can help maintain a consistent visual tone throughout the scene or the project. They also help you save time. Instead of manually adjusting colors for each clip, applying a LUT can save time and give a unified look to your video with just a click of a button. And they also help with experimentation. LUTs can offer a quick way to experiment with various looks and styles, moods for your footage, without starting from scratch each time. You can also save more time by installing the LUTs on your system. And I will cover that in a separate video, which I'll direct you to at the end of this video. So stick around if you're interested in seeing how to do that. In my mind, there's really two reasons you would use a LUT. And the first one is for color correction. And the second one is going to be for creative color grading. If you're unfamiliar, the basics of color correction and color grading and the basic differences, color correction is like making sure all the colors in your picture are accurate and match with one another. You can adjust things like brightness, contrast, white balance to make sure everything looks natural and consistent across your different shots. In Adobe Premiere Pro, you do this using tools like Lumetri Color to fix any issues with the footage. Color grading, on the other hand, is when you apply an artistic touch or creative style to the overall look of the piece. It's where you might make creative choices to give your video a specific look or feel. You can make it warmer, colder, more vibrant, try to create a vintage look, something like that. Whatever suits the story or mood you want to convey in your film or video project. So let's talk about how to use LUTs in Adobe Premiere Pro. Now the first step is to import your footage. I have three video clips here that I'm going to be using. We'll scrub through those real quick. They're all from the same project, and this is some stock footage that I pulled up. Very striking colors in these. Not much we would want to do to them to get them up to standard. The greens are a little intense, but we're going to leave it as is for right now. So basically what happens, you pull your video footage up in here into the timeline in Adobe Premiere, but we're going to be working in the color tab. We have our footage pulled up. So here in the Lumetri color panel, you'll find the option to apply the LUTs. And this panel is going to help you adjust colors and tones in your footage. And if you want to do any minor adjustments to any of these files, let's say for instance, you thought this one was a little too dark. I'm going to bring up the exposure on that one a little bit to kind of match them a little closer. You would do any of those kinds of adjustments here in the basic correction. As soon as you bring up that slider and brighten it, Adobe is going to add the Lumetri effect to that video file over here in the effects tab. And that's just a little side note for you. And like I said, if you're working with like log footage, something like that, you would apply a correction LUT here to get that video clip closer to a standard color profile look. But for the purposes of this video, we're focusing on the creative tab and creative looks. And once you pull up the creative tab here, you'll see this little drop-down box called look. And this is where you're going to pull up your LUTs. Now we're going to click on the drop-down box here at Look, and we are going to browse for the LUTs that are on our system that we want to use. If you don't have any LUTs to practice this with or follow along with, I recommend going to our online store. I just have a brand new Moody Looks LUT pack. You can check those out using the QR code or follow the description down below. And I also have a free LUT there you can download as well if you want to try your hand with that one. So here we have the looks in our Moody Looks Volume 1 pack. I'm going to pull up this first one here, Adventure, and apply that. But since we're working with three separate video files here, and I want them all to look the same because they originally are in the same scene, they look very similar, so I want them to all have a cohesive look. So in this case, I'm going to remove that LUT, and all you have to do if you want to remove a LUT is go back to the drop-down box and go to None, and it's going to remove that LUT. What we want to do is apply an adjustment layer. Now, adjustment layers basically go over top of any video files on the timeline. They're going to be at the top of any layer that you want to affect. So you're going to go over to your project window where all of your files are sorted here. And if you'll look at the bottom right, you'll see what looks like a little piece of paper with the corner upturned. That is the new item button. You're going to click that and you're going to go down to adjustment layer. A dialog box will appear. We're going to say OK. And now it's going to place that adjustment layer in our project window. We're going to drag and drop that adjustment layer over top of any of the files that we want to affect. And you'll notice that it's only taking up a small amount of time here on the timeline. So we're going to drag that over to encompass the entirety of the video files we want to affect. Okay. Now let's select the adjustment layer, just like we would any video file on the timeline, and we're going to add our LUT to this adjustment layer. So we're going to go back over to the Creative tab, go to Browse, pull back up our LUT folder, Moody Looks Volume 1. We're going to click on the Adventure LUT that we want to use. And as you can see now, that LUT and that adjustment layer has affected every scene that it's over top of. As you can see, you can click the little eyeball here, cut it on and off. That's with the LUT off. With the LUT on, that looks pretty good without doing anything. And of course, you can fine tune any LUT that you place on any video file or adjustment layer. And over here, you can see the intensity slider. We can move that up and down, and you can see it's affecting how intense that LUT is affecting our video footage. Pretty cool. You can also mess with things like faded film, sharpen, vibrant, saturation. If you want to turn the saturation up, we don't want to do that because that doesn't look good, but you get the point. And if you want to go into even more detail, you can go down into the curves, color wheels, and you can affect these things to your heart's content and get the look you're exactly looking for. The reason you would want to use a LUT is because it just gives you a great starting point for your footage. And once you have that starting point, a look similar in the ballpark to what you're going for, it saves you a lot of time because you get it pretty close and then you can dial it in exactly how you want. And they're pretty inspiring. You know, sometimes you might see a look or a color for a video and it gives you a mood or a look that you want to try and recreate in your own video projects. Remember, while LUTs are handy, they might not always be the perfect fit for every clip. And sometimes tweaking the settings after applying a LUT can help achieve the desired look for your video. And if you want to save even more time, you can actually install the LUTs on your system so that when you pull up the drop-down box here in the Lumetri panel, your LUTs are automatically just listed over here in this drop-down box so you don't have to pull up the browser window. And if you want to learn how to do that, I'm going to cover that in a second video, which you can watch right here. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. My name is Ryan. This is Camp Films, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.